All right, ct.js. You want to go to this link, click this button, any executable here, just pick the right one. You get two options, CopyScript or JavaScript for your language. I'm going to pick JavaScript because I'm cool. You can use any of the built-in projects, write or run, see how you should use the engine with the code there. Lots of examples, but I'm going to make a game from scratch. V4 Showcase, Chad Script, boom, new project. I don't need your help. So this is where all your assets will be. Maybe you have absolutely zero artistic talent. Don't worry, ct.js has you covered. It's got pre-made assets built in the engine. Just pick one that looks good. You can select a single one like this, but I want the whole thing in this pack, so I'm gonna press import all. It's gonna blasticate your directory with all the textures, so I'm gonna move into a folder first before I click the button. Oh my god, look at that guy groove. So you got a bunch of options here. I'm gonna set the pivot point for the character to the bottom middle, just a pro tip if you're making a platformer. I'm gonna press fill, adjust the mask. This will make our collision mask setup nice and symmetrical when we flip the sprite later to have the character look left. So let's say you want to make this game two player. Oh my god, you gotta set up the collision mask again. No you don't. There's a copy button here, click it, and then you paste the new texture. Bam, collision mask copied. Don't forget to set the rotation, it doesn't get copied over. Your collision mask will be all messed up if you don't do this. Alright, let's make a room and put some stuff into it. First. Okay, gonna set the background. This texture pack has some good ones already. There we go. Texture's not marked as a background. CTGS will fix this for us. Great. Set the depth to really low. It means the background will stay in the back. Now, we don't actually have anything to put in yet. You can't just use textures, so let's make a template. First template, this will be our player. Get our beige alien boys set up there. Okay, put him in the room. UI's a little bright for my tastes. One moment. Yeah, that's much better. Alright, first launch of the game. Let's see how it looks. Incredible. Okay, it's not really a game until you can control it, so let's add some controls. CTGS uses an action system that abstracts out needing to hook up each button with code. So I'm just going to assign W, up arrow, and spacebar to all do the same thing. Jump. And that's it, we have jump. Pro tip for moving horizontally, just map it all to the same action. Call it move X. So we're gonna set up A, D, left arrow, right arrow. Now for the left movements, set the multipliers to -1. This will be useful for later. Now that we have actions, they're super easy to get set up as events in a template. So go to add event, find action down. There's our stuff. Gonna implement moving first, so move X. Here we read our move X value based on player input, give it a boost, assign to player's horizontal speed. Okay, let's test it out. Oh my god, he's so talented. You should probably stop when you let go of the button, so make an action release event for MoveX. And pretty easy, just set H speed to 0. There you go, the boy stops now. You can use this to access object props. This is just regular JavaScript. And yes, there are global variables. Actions object is global, so are a bunch of other objects. See this value local here? Another pro tip, since we're in an action event, we automatically get the value for the action to that name. You just shorten the code like this. Oh, all these globals, my polluted global namespace. Shut up. Made some grass. Well, I didn't make it. Grass is too large to tile properly. We can change the cell size of the grid in the room to fix that. Should be 128 by 128. Much better. Gonna make the player stop falling when he hits the grass block. I'll make a collision with the grass event. So you may be tempted to just set the V speed to 0 here, set gravity in the creation event, call it good. Well, guess what? You're dumb, he goes through the ground. So why didn't that work? Here's where the docs are your friend. You're always close to the documentation of this engine. Just click on the side button. You can write notes for the project, access docs page, and module specific docs. Bug has something to do with the move function and the frame start event. So we're gonna go to the place module. We can tell it to move while accounting for collision groups, but we aren't using a collision group, so let's fix that. Go back to grass, there's a collision group field in it. I'm gonna name it solid. Now I'm gonna change my event from collides with grass to collides with collision group solid. This is better because you just need one collision event and you can set a bunch of templates to be part of the solid group. All right, now instead of regular move, we're gonna use move smart. It'll take the collision group into account now. Now we can test this out. Congrats. Alien's not in quicksand anymore. Moving these templates to their own folder, kind of like how textures have their own folder. And in you go. Oh, crap, I put them in textures. Oh my god. It's okay, I can just move him out with a drag and drop. You can multi-select with click while holding down the control key. There's this hierarchy view I can make appear and just drag it to the templates folder. Alright, crisis averted. So we need the place module docs again because the lad needs to learn how to jump. It has an occupied function. It lets us check at a position if there's something there. I'm going to check 1 pixel below the player for a solid collision group. If it's true, that means the player's grounded and he can jump. Writing this on jump down. Now I'll set the V speed to negative to fling him up. Try it out. Whoa, bit high. Works though. Wait, he fell way too fast there. I think V speed isn't being reset. When you don't know what's going on, you can always just console log. Just like JavaScript. See that console in the sidebar? That's where it should be logging my string, but it isn't. The MoveSmart function handles collision for us, so we don't get the event like we'd expect anymore. So I'm just going to rewrite the jump and collision logic to the frame start event. This event runs on every frame. I can do proper checks in there, still check for the solid ground here. I just need to read the state of the button presses from the actions object if the player pressed jump. Otherwise, set V speed to 0. Let's test this out. See that on the right there? There's my owies. Jump still works, now I can check if he falls from a platform normally. See, it's easy when you're not dumb. Alright, I don't want my whole game to exist on one screen, I want to stretch my level out. Easy fix is to set a camera follow target in the room settings. Let's see what this does. Okay, the camera is panning up and down, which I don't want. In the creation event, you can set the camera to follow the player and disable the Y movement with follow Y equals false. See? Easy. The room feels too small, so I changed the size of it, but now my camera and objects are all messed up. I'm going to try and adjust the background first so that it fits within that rectangle in the room. I'm also removing repeating textures in the Y direction, because it's just hard to look at in the editor. Yeah, move all that stuff down too. Okay, for realsies, I'm fixing the camera this time. I'm not going to use code at all. The room editor has a tool for adjusting the camera already. Set the follow to the player here. You click on that Keep Camera and Rectangle checkbox, and then gives you a new rectangle to play with. I'm going to extend it farther to the right, and then we'll be in business. Look at that. Camera doesn't even show what's to the left anymore. Oh, I should probably remove that owie log. This game needs some enemies. Here's a spongy boy. Let's add this one in. It's got 2 sprites to work with. Okay, set up the collision masks on both, use the copy pasta tool for the other texture, ready to go. Made a template that moves it in one direction, changes direction when it hits something solid. Pretty simple stuff. Here's the code. I flipped H speed by setting the current value to negative, and I set the X scale of the texture depending on the H speed. So the slime's not animating yet, so I gotta put in a timer so it automatically swaps between the two textures. The timer1 event works on a special variable called timer1. I set it to 1/2 second, so the event fires after that, and then I'll reset it in the event so it fires itself forever. If it's currently 1 texture, just set it to the other one. Yeah, that's it. The alien needs to be animated. I wonder what those funny numbers up there on each frame are for. I set an animation speed property. This is the function you use to stop the animation, and on what frame. This starts the animation again. Here I loop the frames back to 1 after 5, because all the frames after that aren't about the alien walking. Test it out. He lives. Look at him go. I'm going to make the alien be able to feel pain now. If he touches an enemy, it's game over, and I'll just force restart the room. Room's object has some methods you can use for this. It's just room restart. Making another slime the lazy way, you can just duplicate existing templates to make some new ones. And I'm duplicating the purple one. Just remember to set the textures to the blue ones, and that should be it. Blue slime. ct.js v4 has some cool new template types you can pick from. I'm going to use a sprited counter and try and make a UI for the health over the player. Going to pick the heart here. There's default sprite count to the right here to set. 3 is what I want. See how that looks in the room? Wow, amazing. There'll be iframes too, so you only drop a hit point about every second. Starting HP is 3 here. Iframe logic is in the frame start event. Iframes go down 60 a second and makes the player translucent if he gets hit. Alright. Seems to be working, but the lives label needs an update. Here's the update. I go and search for player templates and just pick the first one. Then I position this template above that player and access its HP property to then set the count here. Alright, one more thing. I saw some artifacts when rendering the hearts in the game I didn't like. Texture just needs some padding to remove those artifacts. Gonna try that. Looks nice. Am I dying? I am. Great. Perfect. So getting hit could use some more pizzazz. ct.js has emitters, like particle effects, so let's make one. And I could use the alien's face as a particle here. Here's what I'm going with. I just need to set the lifetime of the emitter in here so it doesn't loop. Set to 1.5 seconds. See how it says complete up there? So I'll spawn it in this block of code here, emitters.fire. Yeah, that works. I want a title screen, so that means a room, some text, and a button. First, I'm going to make the text, and I don't want it to look normal, so we can do that by making a style. I'm going to up the font size here, set the line height to 0, up the weight a bit, add some color later. Okay, here's what I have. So now I can make a text type template. And when I go to my selection, it just now shows the styles that I made. Great. I'll make it say welcome, put it into the room. Oh, that's a little small. 64 font? Sure, why not? That's better. All right, start button. There's also a button type here. I'm gonna use this crate. And check out all the cool stuff I can do on the right here. Different textures for hover and press actions, setting default text. I can even make the text the style that I made. All right, are you ready for this? No, you're not. Check this out. That's right. 9-slice support in ct.js here. I think the margins need to be a little larger. There's a little bit of stretching, but you can see it doesn't just stretch the whole object. And that's what that slice settings is for. Amazing. It works, but it could use some more animation. There's a catmod for this, so let's check it out. CT transition adds transitions between levels. Gotta enable this one. It also needs tween, so enable that one too. Bringing out the docs again, we can look up the transition module. Here's the tween one. Here's the transition one. Yeah, the slide in will do. I wrote a slide out transition, so when the button's clicked, it will slide the screen to black over half a second, and then when it's done, it loads the next room. But now I need another transition into the level. So you can do that in the room. Rooms have events too. I'm going to use the room start event, and instead of slide out, I will use slide in. Thank you, code completion. Test this mess out. Oh my god. Well, that's a game right there. Well, there's no win condition. It's more of a sandbox, really. So now you got your awesome project and you're ready to share it. Just gonna give it a name here and an ID and show how easy it is to publish. So click on this menu button here. Boom. Watch how fast this is. All zipped up. You can export the desktop too. Just press export in the pop-up here. I didn't speed up this footage, I promise. There's every executable ever. You can now upload that zip to itch, make it a web game, desktop game, get paid, whatever. Also, the engine's free and open source, bye.